Hello, you're welcome to this channel. Today we are going to talk about how to derive the Eadie Hofstee plot from the Michaelis-Menten equation. Alright, so in enzyme kinetics, we have three plots. We have the lineweaver-burk plot, we have the Eadie's plot, and we have the Hinz plot. Alright, so we've already talked about the lineweaver-burk plot. So today we are going to talk about the Eadie Hofstee plot. So this lecture is about to show you how you can derive the Eadie Hofstee plot from the Michaelis-Menten equation. All right, so let's go to the steps. Okay, so steps to derive the Eadie Hofstee plot from the Michaelis-Menten equation. Okay, so the first thing you have to do is to state the Michaelis-Menten equation. And it's given by V equals Vmax times the concentration of the substrate divided by Km, which is the Michaelis constant, plus the substrate concentration. Alright, so this is the Michaelis-Menten equation, and this is what we use to derive all the three types of plots. Alright, so this is what we are going to use to derive the Eadie Hofstee plot. Okay, so let's start with the steps. So after you've written down the Michaelis-Menten equation, the next steps in deriving the Eadie Hofstee plot is to divide both sides of the equation by the substrate concentration S. So as we can see here, we have the normal Michaelis-Menten equation is V equals Vmax times substrate concentration divided by Km plus substrate concentration. So when we divide both sides by the substrate concentration S, is going to be V over substrate concentration, which is S, times this whole equation divided by substrate concentration S. So simplifying it in mathematical terms, we are going to get V, that's the velocity divided by the substrate concentration, equals Vmax times substrate concentration divided by Km plus the substrate concentration times 1 over the substrate concentration. So when you divide something, a division, that's maybe A divided by B, then we can do it A times 1 over B. Alright, so this is how it is simplified. So in mathematical terms, this is how it's going to be. So in further simplification, we have V over the substrate concentration here. We have Vmax times substrate concentration divided by Km plus substrate concentration. So as you can see here, we have substrate concentration here, substrate concentration here. So they can cancel each other and give us velocity divided by substrate concentration equal the maximum velocity divided by Km, which is the Michaelis constant, plus the substrate concentration. Okay, so this is how it's going to be. So in that third step, what you have to do is multiply both sides by the denominator, which is the Km plus substrate concentration. Okay, so this was the normal equation, that was V after simplification. So it was V over concentration of S equal Km, equals Vmax divided by Km plus the concentration of S. So when we multiply both sides by Km plus the concentration of the substrate, this is going to cancel this, so it's going to remain this. Alright, so multiply through and rearrange in order to get Y equal Mx plus C. So this is the equation of a line. So we are going to simplify it and compare it to the equation of a line. So we have V over the substrate concentration times Km plus substrate concentration equal Vmax. So this is how it's going to be. So we are going to multiply Km by V over the substrate concentration, and we are going to multiply V over the substrate concentration times another substrate concentration. So it's going to cancel each other, so it's going to remain V. Alright, so what we can get here, so we are going to rearrange it in the form of Y equal Mx plus C. So that means we are going to get V to stand as the Y component, then Km will be the M, this will be X, and this will be the C, that's the intercept. So we are going to rearrange it. So it's going to be V equals negative Km. So we are going to send this whole thing to the other side. So it's going to be negative. So it's going to be negative Km times V over the substrate concentration plus Vmax. Alright. So as you can see here, we can compare it to the equation of a line. So Y is equal to V, negative Km is equal to M, V over the substrate concentration is equal to X component, and finally Vmax is equal to C, which is the intercept. Okay, so after the comparison, we will make comparison to deduce the value of the Y, X component and the intercept by comparing it to the equation of a line. Alright, so by comparing it to the equation of a line, it can be seen that Y equals V, alright, and X equals V over the substrate concentration, and C equals Vmax. So Y is the Y component, which is equal to the velocity. X is the X component, which is equal to V over the substrate concentration, and C is the y-intercept, the intercept on the y-axis, which is equal to Vmax. All right, so let's try to interpret it on a graph and see what we are really talking about. So this is the y-axis, this is the y-axis, this is the x-axis, and these are the plotted values for the Eadie Hofstee. All right, so we have our velocity here. We have, that's the Y component. We have the velocity over the substrate concentration, which is the X component. Okay, so by plotting this against this, we get this a straight line here with a negative slope. So it's going to be a negative slope. It's not in the case of lineweaver-burk, which was a straight line in this direction with a positive slope. So this is the slope, and the slope is equal to negative Km. So as you can see from the other slide, you can see that the slope, which is the M, is equal to negative Km by comparing it to the equation of a line. So that's how it is. All right. Okay, so we have the Vmax over here. We have Vmax, so the Vmax is the intercept C. So as you can see, Vmax is the C, that's the y-intercept, and it's equal to Vmax. So after plotting the line, you have to make sure the line cuts through the y-axis. So the point of interception on the y-axis is the Vmax, and the slope can be calculated, the Km can be calculated by just calculating the slope. Okay, so it's going to be like this. You find the change in Y over change in X, and that's going to give you negative Km. And the intercept on the X-axis also is Vmax over Km. So that's the intercept on the X-axis. So basically, this is how to derive the Eadie Hofstee's plot from the Michaelis-Menten equation. Okay, so you can see how best you can go with it. So this is Vmax, this is negative Km. So if you get the slope to be equal to negative Km, so that means you have to multiply it by a negative, so to get a positive value for your slope. All right, so that's how it's going to be. And even after calculating either the Km or the Vmax, you can use the intercept on the X axis to find the other components. All right, so that's the simplified form of how you can derive the Eadie Hofstee plot from the Michaelis-Menten equation. All right, so stay tuned to our next video. The next video, we are going to talk about how to use this same Michaelis-Menten equation to derive the Haynes plot. All right, so don't forget to subscribe to this channel, like and make comments, so that in case any video drops, you'll be notified. All right. Thank you very much.